Corals are cnidarians. Cnidarians is a group of animals, around 10,000 species, more or less, relatively simple but very diverse, with many, many forms, including jellyfish, corals, anemones. Stony corals, the corals that everybody knows, they are colonies of very little polyps, basically sacs with tentacles that live in the seafloor, and they have the ability of produce an exoskeleton. And like that, they produce the coral reefs that everybody knows and that are very, very important because they sustain a lot of other animals. They are the base for the whole community, and they actually make deserts into very biodiverse coral reefs.
In our coral collection here at the American Museum of Natural History, we have about a little over 4,000 specimens from all over the world. The collection dates back to about 1873. Some of these collections were donated by amateur collectors or some researchers, or they were considered bycatch. So people would go out on expeditions for other things and would bring back pieces of coral. And then there was an expedition to bring back a reef and to replicate a reef within the museum. And you can see that in the Hall of Ocean Life. It's a spectacular display. But then we have specimens that are for researcher use only.
The collection of dry corals at the MNH is important because it's old. That means that we can travel in time and see how the oceans were 200 years ago.
Nowadays, as people may be aware, coral is becoming increasingly endangered. We decided that we really needed to put this effort into rehousing the coral so that it's available to the outside world.
So we are currently 6 months into our ongoing three-year project to clean, document, and photograph the entirety of the dry coral collection at AMNH. The way that we clean the coral is with a vacuum and a soft brush. Right now we're using watercolor brushes, who knew? Very effective. So after we're all done cleaning, we take the time to photograph all of the specimens with all of their original labels from the donor. And this is because they can be some of the most detailed sources of locality information and the date it was collected in the collector and things like that. Most of the stuff that I've worked with before is an artwork that somebody has crafted in some way, whereas here it was once living and it was grown and nobody has shaped it into this form. My favorite species that I've worked with so far is Acropora spicifera. It's almost like lace, and if you get really up close, it kind of looks like a forest.
One of my most favorite pieces is this single piece of black coral. This piece is just so beautiful and sleek and elegant.
Corals are very beautiful, so I don't think I have a favorite one. Many of the pieces are amazing.
By researchers coming here, carbon dating the coral, and also looking at how environmental conditions have affected the coral, this will absolutely help us understand the fate of corals and how to protect corals going forward in the future.